Hello, welcome to Dramatic Reading Week on All the What. Today I'm going to be reading some. Today I'm going to be reading some Thomas the Tank Engine fan fiction. I mean, there's not really any elegant way to put it. It's just, okay. So also something I really like about this. Person that's done some of these. They have a little series going on called Stories of Love and Friendship, and I just love the way they're so organized about this. They take it so seriously. It's they put the setting, like actually which episode they think their fanfiction chapter, you know, comes after, and that, oh, just inspirational. And they also put the pairing, so you know, like, oh, fantastic. Today I'm going to read you Chapter 1, Truly a Friend. One morning, Percy was at the sheds. He was looking around and smiled. There was never a better home for him than this. Well, of course there's not a better home. He's a fucking train. Of course the train station is... When he looked to his left, he was surprised to see that Thomas was there. Hello, Thomas. I didn't see you there, Percy said. Thomas looked to see Percy and then looked away. Percy was surprised by this. He could see a look of guilt on Thomas's face. It confused him, as Thomas wasn't normally in a mood like this. "What's wrong, Thomas?" Percy asked, concerned. Not responding, Thomas headed out of the sheds, much to Percy's surprise. Oh, that bitch. What could be making Thomas feel like this? Percy wondered to himself. After a bit of thought, Percy could tell what was on Thomas's mind. "I'm sure he needs some help," Percy said to himself. With this, he headed out to find Thomas. Thomas was out by himself. Well, yeah, we know that, like... It did say that he just went off by... Okay. He needed to think to himself for a moment. Even though it's gone by, it still won't leave me alone. Why is that? How come the memory of what happened never goes away? Thomas asked. Just then he could hear Percy next to him. He's a train. Like, could you not hear that, like, he was coming up to you all that way? Surely it's not just, like, silent and then suddenly, choo-choo, but, you know, whatever. Percy? Thomas asked in surprise as Percy pulled up next to him. There you are, Thomas. What are you doing here by yourself? Percy asked. Thomas didn't answer. Instead, he looked down sadly. Percy could tell what was making Thomas sad. It's about the brass band, isn't it? Percy asked. Wait, who are the brass band? Do I need to read up on my... Thomas the Tank Engine? Yeah, it is, Thomas responded, looking up at Percy. Why does it still bother you? I thought you wouldn't remember that by now. Percy explained, wondering why Thomas still thought about this. Yeah, that's true, but it still makes me feel terrible about myself. I still feel guilty, knowing that you trusted me for a long time and I nearly took that for granted, keeping that secret to myself. Even though I didn't want to make you upset, I still did that anyway by not telling you that. Jesus, they sound like a couple. Percy was surprised, but he could tell what was bothering Thomas, so he saw this as a chance to help Thomas. You don't need to worry, Thomas, Percy said. Thomas looked at him in surprise. I guess I overreacted a little when you told me. I knew you couldn't bear the guilt of it, but I took it a little too seriously. I'm sorry, Thomas. I know you wanted to tell me the truth, and I understand, Percy explained. Thomas was amazed when he heard this. It made him feel happier inside. So does that mean you forgive me, Percy? Thomas asked. Of course, Thomas. You're my best friend, and I could never find anyone who could replace you. You're one of a kind, and that makes you a special friend to me, Percy responded, smiling. Thomas smiled hearing this. He could never have a better friend than Percy. It felt wonderful to know that Percy could never find any better friend than him. It made Thomas feel like he mattered to Percy more than he could imagine. Yeah, that was just generally lovely.